Hello, hello, hello. Adam Fleischhacker here to help you unify narrative, math, and code. If you know me from my Bayesian business analytics textbook and the accompanying videos, you know my favorite way of representing real-world uncertainty is with probability distributions. While that previous material had you representing probability distributions in the R ecosystem, today we learn to represent our uncertainty using probability distributions in the Julia ecosystem. Let's say we have a custom distribution we want to use. For our example, let's say it's the Kumaraswamy distribution best represents our real-world uncertainty. So it's a distribution similar to the beta distribution, but it's not available in Julia's distributions package. Julia's package has a lot of distributions, but Kumaraswamy is not there. From the comfort of my room, lift me up in hard to reach. Standing on this mountain peak, I learned fear is just the false belief. There is nothing you can. So here is a coin flip model in Turing. Notice if I try to use a Kumaraswamy 2-2 distribution, we'll call it Kuma for short. Turing gives me an error that Kuma is not defined. This is not surprising. I have not defined this distribution yet. However, if I use a distribution known to the distributions.jl package, like a beta 2-2 distribution, then things run smoothly. I get some output. I'm not concerned whether you can interpret this output. That is for a different video. But what is important is that we recognize the beta distribution is a type of distribution defined within distributions.jl. Specifically, it is a subtype of a univariate continuous distribution, which itself is a subtype of a univariate continuous samplable. Our key to getting the Kuma distribution to work in Turing will be twofold: to define Kuma as a subtype of the distribution type, which by definition will also be a subtype of samplable, and two, to define a few key methods for the Kuma type so that Turing.jl can sample from it as effectively as it samples from the beta distribution. To have a Kumaraswamy distribution object, we define a new parametric composite type, starting with the struct keyword to declare a new type. We will call this new type Kuma and declare that type T must be some type of real number. For our intent, this means that the parameters we supply to a Kumaraswamy distribution will either be integers or floating point numbers. Those are both types of reals. Last thing on this line will be our declaration that our new Kuma type is a subtype, denoted by the less than sign colon combination here, is a subtype of the distribution type, as defined by distributions.jl. The distribution type itself is also parametrically defined. Boy, this gets confusing. So the distribution type itself parametrically defined and requires us to declare our Kuma distribution will be univariate and continuous. Those are the two parameters we pass to the definition of this type. In other words, the Kuma distribution returns one realization at a time and its support is continuous. And since it is a subtype of a type defined by the distributions package, we better go back up here and say using distributions to load up that package for our use. A parametric composite type, like our Kuma type, is really just a collection of Julia objects that we want to treat in some unified manner. For distributions, this is how we collect all the distribution parameters in one place. The Kumaraswamy distribution has two parameters, A and B, and their type T gets declared by the user when instantiating this object.
So all these T's refer to whatever type of parameters the user supplies when instantiating or creating the Kuma object. To write the code that instantiates a new object, I looked at the distributions.jl code on GitHub, and it seemed to encourage using an inner constructor function, which is written right inside of the type definition. Notice this semicolon prior to me writing the check args argument. Every argument in a function definition after a semicolon is a keyword argument, not a positional argument. Because a default value of true is supplied here, this argument becomes optional for users. Assuming the argument is true, we then use the check args macro from the distributions package to enforce that parameters A and B are both greater than zero. We wrap up our inner constructor function by using the new function. This function, named new, only works inside of a type definition, and its sole purpose is to create a function that instantiates new objects. In our case, it creates a Kuma function for a user to define new Kuma types. Now we just test the function to make sure we don't get any errors. And it works. So now we write some outer constructor functions so that we don't have to explicitly supply the type, like the float64 we did above. The first constructor function will handle two parameters supplied as float64 parameters and will instantiate a Kuma float64 object. The next method that we will add for instantiating a Kuma function is if A and B are both real. We will promote A and B to be the same type. And then there's one more function for when A and B are integers, and we will make them float prior to instantiating the new object. When we test it, we pass two integers, 2 and 12, and you can see they were converted to float 64 in the new object. Success! Nobody tells you where you're going. Seems like everyone I know is just an actor. As documented by the distributions.jl team, there are 8 methods which need to be implemented for a univariate distribution. Turns out if we implement those 8 methods, Turing will indeed recognize the Kuma distribution. So I cut and paste the 8 methods into VS Code, make them all comments, and this will allow me to keep track that I'm implementing all 8. Let's do it. So for all of these functions you see here, I don't want to break them. I want to extend them to accommodate the Kuma distribution. So the key to extending other functionality is to use import. So for example, the rand function is in the base module. So I'm going to import base.rand, and this way when I write a rand function, I will extend the base module, not overwrite it completely. Some of these functions, you might not even know where they come from. So there is an at which macro, and we can say, who has the sampler function? And you can see the sampler function comes from the distributions package. Using the at which macro on all of these functions leads me to also want to import a bunch of packages so that I do not overwrite the existing functionality of any of those functions. I use import, not using, I use import with these packages to ensure when I create a new method, I'm not overwriting the function, I'm just extending it. The first function I'm going to write is actually a helper function to extract the parameters of the Kuma distribution. This actually extends the params function from stats base to handle the case where the distribution is a Kuma distribution, or the argument passed to this is of the Kuma type. The function returns a tuple of the two parameters. And actually, for me to extend this stats base definition, it's telling me I have to explicitly import that function. So just like base.rand, we will do stats base.params up here. Control enter, and now if I control enter on my helper function, it is accepted. And you can see there's 82 methods now for the params function. So Kuma got added to it. With our helper function recorded, we'll now go on to create our 8 methods that we need to add a distribution. The first one is the rand method, how to generate a random number from the Kuma distribution. And we'll actually go to Wikipedia and look up the Kumaraswamy distribution and get the quantile function. With the quantile function, we can use a uniform random number generator using the inverse transform method. And we plug in this uniform random variable into the inverse cumulative distribution function, also known as the quantile function. And when we return the output of that function, we will get a random Kumaraswamy random variable. You may notice these blue underlines, and it took me a little while to figure out what they are. It's just a warning that I'm overwriting a method from a existing package. So if I just add the library or package name prior to the function, when I define it, the blue warning goes away. Now, according to our 8 methods, we're going to add a sampler method, which has one argument, a distribution. But actually using that one argument doesn't quite work. So I suggest defining sampler with 2 arguments, and we can just point the sampler to use the rand function we just defined for method number 1. Moving on to log PDF, we're first going to define the PDF function because I have a formula for that PDF function. Again, go to Wikipedia, look at the Kumaraswamy webpage, and you can see the actual formula for the PDF function. When I define log PDF, I just take the logarithm of the PDF function. Now, any experts out there, I have a feeling that I should analytically solve for the log function and it will be faster that way, but I'm not sure. So please leave comments below if you know whether that's true or not. So here's me actually going to Wikipedia and showing you that the PDF function is available there. And then I just have to translate the math from Wikipedia and bring it into VS Code. And like I said, the log PDF will just define as the logarithm of the PDF function. Moving on to the rest of the methods, the recipe is the same, so I'm going to add in a little music and quickly show you each method's code. If you need to pause the video to copy the code, you can do so, or remember the code is also available on GitHub. Look in the show notes and you will find a link